Hi, and welcome to session two in our Coolselector deep dive series. Today, we're going to talk about incompressible flow in pipes. Last time, we talked about the basic energy equation and we developed it in a form that was usable for finding the pressure drop. Let's just write it again. And we also concluded that the thing we really need here is to find an expression for the head loss. And today, we'll try to find an equation for the head loss for incompressible flow in pipes. In the middle of the 18th century, some thermodynamic engineers came up with an expression. And the two guys, the equation they're named off is a German engineer, Weisbach, and a French engineer, Darcy. And the equation, the Darcy-Weisbach equation, goes like this. So it says that the head loss is equal to a friction factor times pipe length divided by diameter, velocity squared divided by 2. Now you might wonder, why do we go through all of this trouble to replace one value, the head loss, with another unknown value, the friction factor? The reason is it's actually easier to come up with correlation for this friction factor. When you look at incompressible flow, you have two different equations for the friction factor depending on the Reynolds number of the flow. If you have laminar flow that is smooth and straight, the friction factor can be expressed as 64 divided by the Reynolds number. That's quite simple. If you have turbulent flow, we use an equation or a correlation developed by an English engineer called Colebrook. I'm not going to write the equation, it's well known and you can find it in the literature. So the question is, when is the flow laminar and when is the turbulent? In Coolselector, you actually have the possibility to decide yourself when it switches from laminar to turbulent, but the limits we have put in as default is that it's laminar when the Reynolds number is lower than 2000. And it's turbulent if you have Reynolds number larger than 3000. So in between here, you will actually have an unknown area. The way we solve that is that if you look at the friction factor as a function of the Reynolds number, and this is the laminar curve, and this is the turbulent curve, then the resulting curve we have is a curve where we create a smooth transition between the two. There's really no physical reasoning for this, but when you do calculations, it's actually clever to do this so that you don't end up in problems. You could also do linear interpolations, but doing it in a smooth way, you end up with something that is reasonably stable. You'll be able to see this in Coolselector. When you select a pipe and you plot the flow or the pressure drop, if you plot the mass flow and the pressure drop, you will see that when it's laminar, the pressure drop rises slowly. You have the smooth transition, and then you go into the turbulent area. But you need to go down to very low flows to be able to see this. But this concludes how we calculate incompressible flow in pipes. Next time, we'll continue to compressible flow and see how we handle this. But until then, you can download Coolselector on the Danfoss homepage, and thank you for watching.